Jay, what does the term Hinduism actually mean?
Okay. The word Hindu, as we have said before, is purely a mispronunciation of the name of an ancient river that flowed in northwest part of ancient India. The river was called Sindhu. Sindhu in Sanskrit means a huge, vast amount of water. That's how we define the river, vast amount of water, river, big river. But then the name of the river was mispronounced from Sindhu to Hindu. The sir was replaced with a her pronunciation. Some people say we blame the Persians, but I think we ourselves may be the culprits. Because people from Kutch have a habit of replacing sir with her sound. Mm. So we may have been the culprit, but so be it. So the name was mispronounced as Hindu. And they say people living across in the tradition that they, you know, subscribe to is called Hinduism. That is how the word Hindu is. Sorry about this technical, this Wi-Fi is blocking us and stops them. Anyway, we'll carry on Facebook. Okay, so you see the word Sanatan Dharma. First of all, let me tell you, the word Hinduism is purely for like mispronunciation name of a river. It's like a pet name we acquire. It's a pet name. Don't be frightened of getting a pet name. When you go to school, children will call you, other youngsters will call you by some pet names. Don't get frightened by it. That's how the world is. So we acquired a pet name, our tradition acquired a pet name called Hindu or Hinduism. So far, so smile and live with it. But then you see, our tradition itself was trying to define itself. And the first term we use was not even Dharma. The word Rita, simply saying, this is how the world operates. This is the way the world operates. This is the way the universe unfolds. This is the way things behave, Rita. So the first word we use makes sense of the world that we live in. We say Rita, this is how things unfold. Full stop, very beautiful, it's philosophically perfect, clean cut. Making sense of the world, saying we observe certain kind of patterns and we say this is the Rita. You know, modern science is nothing but same thing, observing certain patterns and we trying to come to terms with them. And that's exactly how Hinduism started, Rita. Then we change the word from the Rita word was displaced with the word Dharma. Dharma, is the root is Dhara. So he's saying, is there some unity behind this diversity we experience? You see the diversity, material things, living things, non-living things, intellect, emotions. Is there something that's holding everything together, Dhara? What is holding everything together? What is that one out of which is manufactured the diversity we experience in our life? So the word became Dharma. We're exploring the unity behind diversity. That is the meaning of the word Dharma. Then we added an adjective. We said, let's use the word Sanatan Dharma. So we are not looking for an understanding of reality purely on a temporary basis, only suitable for India or one part of the world. It should be a universal phenomena and an eternal phenomena. That means not just a fashionable thing that we are subscribed to 200 years. It must be suitable for many, many years, thousands of years, eternity. So then we use the word Sanatan. Means we are looking for the resolution of what is this all about, which is not just temporary, but eternal. That's why we use the word Sanatan Dharma. Now many people say, Mr. Lakhani, rather than keep using the word Hinduism, why don't you use Sanatan Dharma? I say, look, my friend, once you get a pet name, you are stuck with it. Why you smile and you live with it? And you don't make a big fuss about it. So when somebody says, look, my real name is Jai Prakash, but everybody in my house calls me Dilip. Now suddenly I say, no, call me Jai or Prakash, they'll all run away from me. So I smile and carry on with my pet name. So if somebody says, no, you must give up the word Hindu and start the word Sanatan, I'm comfortable. This is the pet name we acquired. Live with it. What's the big deal?